Hello, my dear students. A very good morning to all of you. So today we are going to start with the concept of natiquity. First of all, what is a natiquity? When you come to school, you follow some rules and regulations like to be polite to your friends, to respect your teachers, to respect your principals, right? So natiquity refers to the word of internet etiquette. Internet etiquette, it means a set of rules and regulations that you have to follow, that you are expected to follow when you are online. So like you have to follow some rules and regulations while coming to the school. In the same way, you have to follow some set of rules while you are working online, while you are searching anything or while you are designing anything online. So that concept is called netiquette. Again, let me repeat it. Netiquette means the set of rules which you are expected to follow when you are working online. Now let us see some of the rules that you should follow, which are listed below. First is be courteous and respectful to others who are online. Courteous, it means be polite, speak politely and with respect to others who are online, who are working with you online. Next is use emoticons. Emoticons, it means emojis. When you are using WhatsApp, you send some smiley faces to your friends. So that is called emojis. But here, in the terms of internet, it is called emoticons. So what are emoticons? Emoticons are the small icons which showing different emotions like sad, happy, crying. By using these emoticons, you can convey your emotions clearly to the recipient, to the person to whom you are talking, to whom you are communicating. Avoid capital letters. Words in capitals draw unnecessary attention and can be considered as being rude. So while you are communicating or while you are writing something online, you have to use small letters. Do not use capital letters because it will be considered as being rude. Next is do not abuse others while participating in a discussion, forum or message boards. Next is before posting any question, do some research on the topic. Do not ask inappropriate questions. So when you are discussing about something, when you are posting any query, any question on some research topic, then first you have to study about it. Do not ask inappropriate questions which are not related to that post. Keep personal information private and do not share with anyone. Contents you see on a web page are protected by a copyright law. Do not steal or use them as your own. Next is people who are new to the internet are called newbies. Underline it or remember it. The people who are new to the internet, who started using internet from now, who are beginners, they are called the newbies. Be patient and helpful to the newbies and teach them what you have learned. Okay, so these are the set of rules which a person should follow while using an internet, while they are online. Next concept is of blogging. The word blog comes from the word weblog. Weblog, coined by John Barger on 17 December 1997. The short form of blog was coined by Peter Merholz, who jokingly broke the word web weblog into the phrase we and blog. Okay, so the original name of blog was weblog. Then the person Peter Merholz have breaked the word into two different parts, one we and second blog. And afterwards it was named as blog. A blog is a website that can be created easily by any user for himself to share his thoughts and ideas with the world. For example, if you want to write something, if you want to present your ideas, your concepts with the entire world, with the people who are using the internet, then you can create your own website. In that website, you can write your own blog, you can write your own ideas, your thoughts. There are many different types of blogs, differing not only in the type of content but also in the way the content is delivered. There are personal blogs for sharing your personal details, for sharing your personal experiences with the world, with the public. Then a corporate blog and an organizational blog. So you can share your personal details, you can share something for the purpose of advertising. You can share some institutional blogs, some organization blogs, then political blogs, traveling blogs, and many other type of blogs. So blog is means a way to present something to the world, to present something to the public who are using an internet that can be helpful for them. For example, if you are writing something on traveling, then you can share your experience. You can share that have you traveled, at what places you travel, where you enjoyed the most, so that it can be helpful to the other persons if they are planning to travel. So the main purpose of blogging is to tell something, to tell your own personal thoughts, your personal experience to the world, to the public. The topic of the blog can be anything. It can be personal, it can be professional, it can be social, it can be political, or any topic on any subject. Most good quality blogs are interactive, allowing visitors to leave comments to a blogger's posting. Okay, so with this we are finishing our chapter. Let us move towards the keyword. First is BCC. The full form of BCC is blind carbon copy. Next is blog. A blog is a website to share ideas and thoughts. CC stands for carbon copy. Email, electronic mail. Login, it means to opening an email account. Logout, to close an email account. Netiquette, it means internet etiquette, or you can write the set of rules a person should follow when they are online. Newbies are the people who are new to the internet. These keywords you have to write in your computer notebook, and the exercises like true, false, filling the blanks, you have to write in your computer textbook, while the descriptive exercises like question answers you have to write in your computer notebook. Again, I repeat, the keywords and the descriptive exercises you have to write in your computer notebook, while the formal exercises you have to write in your computer textbook. Okay, so with this we are finishing our session today. We will continue with the next chapter in our new session. For now, bye-bye. Have a great day ahead.